Hello students, welcome back to MJC Learn. We are going to continue our chapter Transition and Inner Transition Elements of Chemistry. This is part 12th of this chapter. So let's begin. We have already studied about compound of manganese, that is KMnO4, also known as potassium permanganate. Now let's learn one more compound of transition elements, that is compound of chromium, that is K2Cr2O7. We will also see what is potassium dichromate and how we can prepare potassium dichromate. So compound of chromium, that is K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate. Now let's see what is potassium dichromate. So potassium dichromate, that is K2Cr2O7, is a common inorganic chemical reagent most commonly used as a oxidizing agent. It is also a very good oxidizing agent as KMnO4, and it is a crystalline ionic solid with a very bright red orange color. As you can see here, this is the potassium dichromate, which is crystalline and very bright orange color. Now let's move towards the preparation of potassium dichromate. So potassium dichromate is manufactured or prepared using chromite ore. In preparation of KMnO4, which we have done previously, pyrolusite ore is used. Here it is chromite ore is used in the preparation of potassium dichromate. So K2Cr2O7, that is potassium dichromate, is prepared from chromite ore, which is also known as chrome iron ore. Compound of chromite ore is FeOCr2O3. Now conversion of chromite ore into potassium dichromate, there are 4 steps involved. So following steps are: step 1, concentration of ore. Now in this step, ore, that is chromite ore, is concentrated with current of water, that is in hydraulic classifier. It is an type of machine in which powdered chromite ore is washed with water current. The lighter gangue is washed away with the water current, means using current of water, lighter unwanted or valueless material is carried away by the water, and the heavier chromite ore, which is useful for the preparation of potassium dichromate, is concentrated or settled at the bottom. Now in step 2, chromite ore is converted into sodium chromate. This step is called as roasting. Here in step 2, conversion of chromite ore into sodium chromate, which is known as roasting. Roasting means heating the ore in air. So generally dichromate is prepared from chromates. So we have to first convert chromite ore into sodium chromate. So dichromates are usually prepared from chromates, and this is obtained by combination of chromite ore with sodium and potassium carbonate in presence of air. In short, chromite ore is treated with sodium carbonate in presence of air. So this is the reaction given. Here this is the chromite ore, which is reacted with sodium carbonate in presence of air, and we will get the sodium chromate, and these are the side products. So first we have to balance the equation or this reaction. So 4FeCr2O4, 8Na2CO3 in presence of 7O2 gives 8Na2CrO4 plus 2Fe2O3 plus CO2. So water soluble, this sodium chromate is water soluble. So water soluble sodium chromate, that is yellow in color, is separated from water insoluble substances in the solution. So this is yellow in color and it is extracted by the solution and it is in water soluble. So it is extracted by the solution with water, and we will use the filtration method for the extraction of sodium chromate. Now in step 3, sodium chromate, which is prepared in step 2, is now converted into sodium dichromate. So first chromite ore is converted into sodium chromate. Now sodium chromate is converted into sodium dichromate. So in step 3, conversion of sodium chromate into sodium dichromate. Basically here chromate is converted into dichromate. So the yellow solution of sodium chromate, which is prepared in step 2, is filtered and acidified with sulfuric acid to give a solution from which orange sodium dichromate can be crystallized. So this is the reaction where sodium chromate is acidified in presence of sulfuric acid and it gives a solution which crystallizes, and we will get the orange sodium dichromate. This is sodium dichromate. Now sodium sulfate is less soluble in water, so it can be separated by filtration, and the filtrate obtained is concentrated solution of sodium dichromate. So here also we can use the filtration method to separate the sodium dichromate from the solution. Now this sodium dichromate is used in next step, which is fourth step, in which sodium dichromate is converted into our final product, that is potassium dichromate. So here conversion of sodium dichromate into potassium dichromate. Now potassium dichromate can be obtained by reacting a solution of sodium dichromate with potassium chloride. So this is the reaction where sodium dichromate Na2CR2O7 is reacted with potassium chloride to give potassium dichromate and NaCl. Now we have to balance the equation. So it is Na2CR2O7, 2KCl gives K2CR2O7 and 2NaCl. So the resulting solution, which is potassium dichromate and NaCl, is concentrated and then the hot solution is cooled. Orange red crystals of potassium dichromate are obtained by the crystallization. These crystals are further purified by recrystallization. There is a amount of NaCl also present in the solution. So by recrystallization, pure potassium dichromate is obtained, as sodium chloride is more soluble than potassium dichromate. So it remains in the solution and crystals of potassium dichromate is obtained, which is a very bright orange color. So this is the preparation of potassium dichromate. There are mainly four steps. First is concentration of ore, that is chromite ore. In second step, chromite ore is converted into sodium chromate. In third step, sodium chromate is converted into sodium dichromate. And in final step, sodium dichromate is converted into potassium dichromate. And we will get the crystals of ऑरेंज कलर पोटेशियम डाइक्रोमेट. थैंक यू.